of Black Liberation Network is Doc Ross Shalom. He is an herbal biochemist and owner of Shalom Health Services out of Jacksonville, Florida. So if you guys would welcome him to the floor so he can give us some good. Thank you, Dr. Shalom.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
I'm so glad that you were able to make it here this afternoon and share with me and build up together. And that's what we're pretty much about, Black Liberation Network. It's about us, each one teach one, being able to build and grow one another. And we're here because we really resonate with one another. We have a magneticism with each other because we, on this planet, we all look for someone to on the same frequency. So that's why you guys are here. And we're here to share and build. So I want to pretty much go over a health consciousness journey that we'll be talking about. All right. Look what I got. I got people that share with me their stool pictures. They share with me more than y'all probably know. It's online and I don't call nobody out.
I got the best stool.
Best pictures. They sent the best pictures.
I don't call nobody out. Yeah. Most Americans, they consume a lot of animal products. These constipating foods, these dry foods. You should be having a lot of water foods so you don't have this type of constipation. Squeezing out these little small pebbles. This is what I call this little small pebble. This is type one. So I decided to play a little game and start showing actual pictures of stools. I'll try to see that way. But,
so should it be like a type four? Okay.
You got all the answers.
I'm sorry.
But type one is the small lumpy, small pebbles.
Right.
Type two, you got the sausage-like lumpy stuff together. It's kind of hard to pass. And type three, you got the sausage-like, kind of smooth with cracks on the side of it. Type four is the soft, put together, real smooth like a snake. And then we got the type five, which are the soft gobbles and grid logs. It's really kind of easy to push out. Then you got type six, which are rough edges, really, really soft, mushy. And then you got type seven, which is watery, liquid. So which one would be?
It's type four.
Type four.
Of course, the one with the sundaes.
Yes. Cool one with the fruits and vegetables, all that. Your stool tells how healthy you are. You know, if you're having some hard stools, you know that you're constipated. How long do you actually spend on the toilet? How long do you think people should spend on the toilet? Like, you can give an answer. People be skipping work just to be on the toilet. I know that sometimes. So
I know.
20
minutes?
20 minutes? No.
No.
That's too long?
It's too long.
2 minutes?
No. I don't know. I spend probably less than 2 minutes and I have a lot of
time. 5 minutes or less.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't spend that long. But
if you're sitting on the toilet that long, you're probably straining and then that backflow comes back up from the abdomen. And what happens is the blood flow comes back down and it passes on these piles, what they call hemorrhoids. And sometimes those piles will build up and then they either cause in your leg down there, you have varicose veins. So that's the reason why people have varicose veins is because of their constipation.
Oh, wow.
Constipation can stop you from urinating or cause ureus, where bedwetting for kids.
Wow.
Because they're constipated.
But we have a question, Dr. Shalom, why you do that?
Yes, please.
Now,
do you have a prescribed posture for elimination, for evacuating?
Yes, it's a lot of people are on this 90-degree, sitting on regular toilets, on white toilets. We should be at an angle at least 45 degrees to 35 degrees. In the angle, some people need to find a better angle for their sitting style. I encourage those to get a squatty potty so that they can have a better release. It helps a lot.
If they can't squat?
Yes, it helps a lot.
I got a question for you guys.
Have you ever wondered what's inside of your poop or your stool?
Yes.
You ever wondered like what's really there?
Yes.
Anybody got an idea what's there?
In my mind, I think I do.
Somebody give you some ideas.
I would venture to say maybe some, if there are meat eaters, then there's excretion from the meat that they're eating.
Undigested proteins, and
I guess maybe waste from your own bodily organs.
Of course, bacteria. Anybody else got another idea?
I've seen what I think was fat inside my stool before.
Some adipose.
What about mucus?
That's it.
Mucus is going to be there also. Fat.
That was the first time.
Where it floats on the toilet.
Yeah,
that was. You can say the globules. It's actually gallbladder issues, right?
That was the first time. I didn't research this, but that was the first time I came to my conclusion that, oh, we lose fat through our stool. That's what I was thinking. Like, oh, that's, where does the fat go, you know?
So,
I guess that's the premise behind all these weight loss pills is those pills are, I guess, really diuretics, and the same concept that you're losing your fat through your stool, and the more you excrete, the more fat you're expelling from your body, at least from the inside, I guess. That's the marketing gimmick.
So I got this little story I need to tell you guys. I want you to imagine yourself as your favorite food.
Uh-oh.
Whatever your favorite food is, just imagine yourself being that food. Okay? You're chewing, you're not chewing, it's somebody else's chewing.
Uh-oh.
Okay? You're going down this esophagus, close your eyes, kind of, you can picture this, really picture yourself. You know, close your eyes. So it going down the esophageal, it goes down the sphincter, goes down into this stomach acid. You being transformed into this liquid now all of a sudden. Okay? But you still know what you are. So you see at the bottom of the stool, bottom of the stomach, you see the sign that says car wash. There's a car wash right there. And you see the sphincter, it's another pyloric sphincter right there. And once everybody coming out, it drops down inside of it. So on one side of it, you see this, oh, it's green squirts, green fluid. That's our bile. That's for our fat metabolism. Then on the other side, you're going down. Oh, there's some pink fluid. You know, that's our pancreatic fluid. That's for sugar metabolism. So all of a sudden, you see this sign that says ecosystem. Close your eyes and picture the ecosystem, what it looks like. Now these are like these finger-like structures, like little trees almost as you're going down. You're going in a little roller coaster going down. And you're hitting bumps and curves, and you're going down, and you know they grab you, making you smaller and smaller, smaller and smaller. You're in this little liquid going down, but you come to the end of that line, and you like ask the person that's in front of you, like, who is this? What are we waiting on? What are we waiting on? And you say, I think we in the line for Club Coke. Now we're going to Club Coke. Okay. But when we look up, we see these other things that are still grabbing us. They're still grabbing us. So this is where the B vitamins, where the duodenum is at. The B vitamins is being absorbed at this point. And this line is really, really long trying to get through here, trying to get into the club code. So When we finally make it in, they put this little wristband on us and it says species. We didn't expect that. So, as we made it in, it's kind of crowded in there. They say, Club Chloe be lit, you know? So everybody's in there, they're getting fermented.
That's the other word, being drunk.
So you go to the bar, you see this bacterium flagellus. She likes to turn up, make inflammation. All right? So we mingling and everything, the bacterium flagellus cell. I think that the appendix and the officers are the lymphatic cells. I think they're trying to turn the party down. They're trying to, just trying to cut everything off. So we're not gonna let that happen, all right? So I go back and I go mingling with the staphylococcus. I'm mingling with E. coli. I'm mingling with Clostridium, Bifidobacterium, all those different types of bacteria that's down in the colon. So here we are, we having fun, and all of a sudden I feel something bite me. So, oh, a little pinworm right there. They call that the Vermicomus, I forget the whole entire name, but it's the Vermicomus interruptus. That's what the pinworm is. And then I look up and I see another worm on a wall. He's just hanging up there, and I call him the Nectator Americanus. That's our hookworm. They like to stick on the side of the colon. All right? So it's getting kind of creepy here. I gotta get out of here. You know, our favorite food. This is our favorite food. And finally, we hear something that says, cybo coming through. Man, it's this game called small bacteria, a small intestine bacterial overgrowth. That's what cybo stands for. And they make everybody stick to the wall. Everybody's stuck to the wall all of a sudden. So soon as the officers hear this, that this is happening, this is our lymphatic cells. They are immune cells, right? Lymphatic cells are immune cells. So they turn on the sprinklers. Everybody got to get out of here, right? So this is what happens. The bacterial flagellus turned up the inflammation, and then the immune cells put the fire out. Cause diarrhea, and now everybody's going out to this little hole called the anus rectum. And this is where you get oxidized and then down into the toilet. So that's pretty much what I wanted to share. I had a little screen here. I ain't play it at the same time, but this is what's going on inside of the colon. I wanted to say these are more like our, that's a polyp that grows right there, a security guard that got stuck inside the polyp, because everybody has to run out of the club. That's what happens when you talk about it. All right. So I just tried to put together a little story for you guys to understand what's inside of our stool, the bacteria that's there, how diarrhea actually starts, and we have to get rid of waste. Now, we need us to know how to clean out our exit routes. Cancer, colon cancer, is one of the things I'm very familiar with, and that is one of the three causes of death, you know, in America and most African Americans. So we need to be careful and what we put inside of our bodies and become more conscious of what we put in our bodies.